During the sixth week of embryonic life, while maxilla and mandible are developing, a thick band of epithelium forms around the upper and lower jaws. This thick band roughly resembles horseshoe in shape. If we zoom in this area under a microscope, we will see a superficial layer of primary oral epithelium resting on the underlying ectomesenchyme. The superficial layer of oral epithelium is separated from the underlying ectomesenchyme through a layer of the basement membrane. As the seventh week arises, the primary oral epithelium will subdivide into vestibular lamina and the dental lamina. The vestibular lamina will give rise to the oral vestibule, while the dental lamina will give rise to the future dentition. Within just a few days, localized epithelial thickenings will become apparent on the dental lamina. These localized epithelial thickenings are now called the dental placoids. And dental placoids plays the main role in the initiation of tooth formation. The process of development of teeth from these dental placoids is thought to be a continuous process, which means that no clear-cut boundary is present within its developmental stages. But for descriptive purposes, the developmental process is divided into three main stages, namely the bud stage, the cap stage, and the bell stage. The bell stage is further divided into the early bell stage and the late bell stage. In this video, our focus of concern will be the bud stage and the cap stage only. In the bud stage, which starts at the 8th week of intrauterine life, the localized epithelial swellings, or the dental placoids, proliferates and invaginates further into the ectomesenchyme and occupies the shape of a bud. The cellular density of the ectomesenchyme also increases and it becomes densely packed around the epithelial bud. Here at this stage, the namings are changed. The tooth bud here is now called the enamel organ because it will give rise to the enamel of the tooth, and the condensed ectomesenchyme is called the dental papilla. It will give rise to the future dentine and pulp of the tooth. The dental lamina is short and close to the oral epithelium at this stage. As the developmental process enters into the cap stage, which starts at the 9th week, the enamel organ drags along with it part of the dental lamina and occupies the shape of a cap, sitting on the condensed wall of the dental papilla. The cells lying at the concave region of the cap-shaped enamel organ become short columnar and are now called the inner enamel epithelium, while cells lying at the convex region become short cuboidal and are now called the outer enamel epithelium. The cells present in between the inner and outer enamel epithelium secretes glycosaminoglycans into their extracellular compartment. These molecules of glycosaminoglycans are hydrophilic, and as a result, they pull water from their surroundings into the enamel organ, causing the cells to force apart. As a result, the cells become star-shaped and are now called the stellate reticulum. But still, the cells remain connected with each other and with the underlying inner enamel epithelium through their desmosomal junctions. The successional dental lamina of the permanent tooth also arises at cap stage of tooth development, and it will give rise to its permanent successor. Cells of the ectomesenchyme surrounding the enamel organ and the dental papilla are now called the dental follicle or the dental sac. The dental follicle will give rise to the periodontal tissues of the tooth. Together, the enamel organ, the dental papilla, and the dental follicle makes up the tooth germ. If you think this video was helpful, give a thumbs up and subscribe my channel. You can also ask questions in the comment box and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.